guys, so it's officially holiday season. We started November 30th. We put our tree up and everything, but
we put our tree up in November, like first week.
Yeah, we were just too excited. I needed something to look forward to, but we decided to do a holiday try-on haul.
Just random things that we bought that are holiday-ish.
We thought it was a few things, but I think we have quite a few.
Yeah.
Okay, so we're gonna start off with the pajamas that we bought because those are the only clothes that we've been wearing.
What's the point buying clothes during like COVID time?
But the first pair that we bought are these matching pajamas. We actually got one with our friend as well because we wanted to get a matching set for so long. And it took us a while. How many years? Like
2-3 years, I think.
Exactly.
To find something cute that like matches all our personalities and stuff. So
we found this one. And it's like, what does it say?
Hot chocolate, cozy socks, and chill time.
Yeah,
it's so adorable.
It was perfect. And I love the print on the pants. And it was so funny, like how we were struggling to find three of them because we went to Marshall's and I don't know, but Marshall's kind of has like a random selection, so you're not guaranteed three sets.
Yeah.
So I looked through every single rack and I'm like, guys, there's only two, we don't deserve it. And then my sister looked through the same rack.
And I found it, but guess what? I don't know what to tell you.
But yeah, so this is the one we settled for. It was $25, which is kind of more than what we'd give a pajama set.
We usually buy them when they're on sale anyway, like after Christmas, so it was kind of on the expensive side, but still a pretty good deal. Next, we got more pajamas, in case you're wondering. We got this candy cane one and this like plaid one. I didn't get these, she did. I didn't even go shopping with her, so you can explain your selection process on these.
Well, I guess we were just looking for fuzzy pajamas, and it's from Walmart, so very bougie, and it was $10, so it was good.
It's
super comfy, and I don't think we have like proper flannel pajamas, right?
Yeah.
I feel like we used to, but it wasn't the good quality.
These are super soft.
Yeah. So the first one I was going for is that flannel one, and then we also decided the candy cane one because it was cinched. Like most of our pajama pants aren't cinched, and now we've become pajama experts, and really it has to be cinched at the bottom and perfect amount of fuzzy, but it's super cozy, so in Canada it gets like
cold.
So we're ready.
So we went to Bath & Body Works and we kind of ran out of perfume. So the first one we got is this one. It's a vanilla mocha cafe. It's like all of our favorite scents in one. And it smells really good and it reminds me of like the holiday. The other one my sister got was this one called Dahlia. Yeah, the sad story is we always get warm vanilla sugar. That's like our classic go-to scent, but they were out. And the lady recommended this thing, so it was the closest scent they have to it.
Yeah, she said they use something that's like a vanilla note to it, but I think it's more florally.
Yeah.
Is that a word?
Yeah, florally.
Than warm vanilla sugar. So it's not our go-to, but it's still really nice, and to be honest, I love the packaging.
Yeah, the packagings are so cute.
So last year, it was last year, right?
Yeah.
I went to Bath & Body Works, and I found this like beautiful candle.
So pretty.
It smells like hot chocolate, and the packaging.
It's hot cocoa and cream.
Hot cocoa
and cream.
I think
the cream makes it.
Yeah, it smells so good. It was like $12 each for this big one. I think it was during some kind of sale though for Bath & Body Works. So I got one for myself and I got one for my friend. But this year I was looking for a fall candle and well, I guess they got this after fall though. Guess how much this candle is? I just want to show you compared to the size of my
it's
face.
A big candle.
It was $1.75. So I ran and I got it.
As you can see, all the candles behind us, she's been like on a candle spree. She's got a peach one when like summer was ending, she was just buying all these candles.
Yeah, but it was also $1.75 and you can never get this big of a candle for a dollar. But I bought all these candles, I was going on a candle craze and we had nothing to light our candles with. It was so awkward. So we would just stare at it, we'd sniff it and put it back and then you found it.
Yeah, so we used to use like matches. But when we started getting these bigger candles, we couldn't like put the small, we had the tiny matchsticks. We could have bought bigger, like those longer ones.
Yeah.
But like I burned my nail off once trying to like go in and try to get it lit.
And then Amma's technique.
Oh yeah, my mom's just like setting paper on fire on the stove and then dropping it into the candle and then letting it like flame up and it'll just smell like burnt paper the whole day. Okay, so this looks like it's a candle, unless you can see by the handle. Oh, that random candle. Anyways, but it's a Friends cup that we wrapped up for our cousin. She's a big Friends freak, I guess, like she loves the show. And I thought it'd be funny to wrap it up in this like Bath & Body Works thing that they gave us at the mall. And then we wrote from Rachel and Monica, so hopefully she gets it. I'll try to find a picture of the cup that we actually got because I wrapped it. I don't want to unwrap it now.
The last little gift I added in here is just a small Bath & Body Works candle.
Spiced gingerbread.
Yeah, and
can I smell it?
It smells good. It seems like a scent that you would like more though, because it's stronger.
It's like super Christmassy.
Yeah. So H&M had a sale when we went in, mm-hmm. back when the stores were open. I think mm-hmm. we were there on the last day of stores
yeah,
were open.
Yeah, it's like right before Black Friday week.
Yeah, and H&M has like really good selection of like blanket scarves. There was like this color, and there was also like a pinky nude color that was really mm-hmm. nice, but we thought this color would go with everything, mm-hmm. and it was on sale, and we got it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So now we're moving into a little bit of the random things that we got just here and there. Mm-hmm. So I don't know if you've seen a really big theme throughout our little holiday haul is coffee, hot chocolate vibes. Mm-hmm. So we've been really experimenting with hot chocolate.
Like the flavor.
Yes.
Too.
So I used to think, I had this false belief that I made the best hot chocolate.
Gosh.
And my sister said she forgot how it tastes. And it was my go-to recipe.
The sad thing is I taught you that recipe.
You didn't teach it, you just sent it to me.
That is called teaching.
And I made it.
Oh, God.
That is not called teaching.
That's called teaching.
But she forgot. Can you imagine how mad I was? But yeah, so we've been experimenting with hot chocolate recipes. We started off with just melting chocolate, pouring in the milk. Mm-hmm. But now our secret ingredient is hazelnut creamer. Mm-hmm. It literally makes it taste like a Ferrero Rocher. Is
yeah.
that how you can say it? I can never pronounce that. And then my sister got a new cocoa powder. It's this Hershey's cocoa powder. And we're like obsessed with making hot chocolate now.
So the next thing we got was this Halloween cookie house set. So basically we bought everything after it went on sale. And we're gonna use these to make a Christmas, like a gingerbread house kind of thing. But it's like a chocolate cookie house kit.
That's called Finessing Christmas for a cheaper price.
It was 94 cents.
Yeah.
Can you believe that?
Like usually like a Christmas kit is about like $10.
Yeah.
I got it after Halloween for
this
94
is
cents.
Kind of brown way of doing things.
Yeah. And lucky for us, you know how to make icing in different colors. So it's probably gonna taste better anyways.
Thank you. That's
and
okay.
we're good. And then we can snack on the Halloween candies while we're making it.
Wow, I didn't think about that part.
Seemed like a win-win.
She got all these three waterfalls. She kind of went ham.
Basically, I have a bad habit nowadays of seeing things on sale that I might not necessarily need, mm-hmm. but the price is so good that I get it.
Mm-hmm.
Because
it's been a problem with you.
Yeah, but it's like we've been losing the stuff we bought.
That's
it's just, do we need it? I don't think so. But yeah, I saw like a bunch of people at the store grabbing like 11 of these water bottles, mm-hmm. or I guess they're thermos. They're like, you can store hot
yeah.
or cold in it,
mm-hmm.
and it keeps it warm for like 5-6 hours,
mm-hmm.
right? So I saw a lady grab like 11. I'm like, why is she grabbing that much? So I go and it was 94 cents each when the original price was $10 or like $10.95.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought it was a steal. I got three in three different colors in case I want to switch it up.
She went kind of ham.
But we've been drinking our coffee in it and it's
at home.
Yeah.
Over the summer we've been going to our uncle's house, so we got them a gift. We got these super cute like Christmas holiday cups,
mm.
and it's so cute. It has like red cardinals. They're like obsessed with birds, so I thought that would be on brand. And there's like a deer, and it's so cute. I kind of wish I got myself one. It's so pretty.
Yeah, because they have their own like huge secret garden,
mm-hmm.
and they're just very into nature. So we thought this would like be perfect for them.
Yeah,
and they love coffee too. So
mm-hmm.
they have like a little matching thing going to them. Those are all like the things that we've been spending our money on. But yeah, like I think it was good purchases. Like we're either giving it or we're actually using it. So yeah, hope you enjoyed this holiday.
Christmas haul. I think.
Whatever it is.
Something like that.
And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.